Welcome to a video on factoring a perfect square trinomial. To factor a perfect square trinomial, we need to be able to recognize perfect squares. So if we have a trinomial where the first term is a perfect square, the second term is a perfect square, and the middle term is twice a times b, it will be a perfect square trinomial. So if we take a look at this first formula, notice the first position of the two binomial factors is equal to one factor of a squared. The second term of the two binomial factors are equal to one factor of the third term. And notice that both binomials are sums. And this comes from the fact that the middle term is positive, or we see a plus sign here. The result is two equal factors, and therefore we can write a plus b squared. Now everything is the same in the second formula, except now the middle term is negative, where we have minus 2ab, and therefore both binomials are a difference. And again, if the first term is a squared, we'll have a factor of a in the first positions. And if the third term is b squared, we'll have a factor of b in both binomials. So we have the quantity a minus b squared. Now this is a lot to remember. What I suggest is, if you notice the first term and the third term are perfect squares, we'll go ahead and set this up and just check it, because sometimes it's hard to recognize the middle term being twice a times b. Now we have encountered these types of problems before when we looked at a leading coefficient of 1, or when the first term was x squared. X squared is a perfect square, so if we put one factor of x here and one factor of x here, and then notice that the third term is also a perfect square, and since 5 squared equals 25, we could put one factor of 5 here and one factor of 5 here. And then lastly, since we have minus 10x, we have two differences. And the way we can check this is to check the inner product and outer product to make sure we have a negative 10x. And we do. We have negative 5x as the inner product, negative 5x as the outer product, which does give us a negative 10x. Since we have two equal factors, we can write this as the quantity x minus 5 squared. Now I do want to mention, while this formula is a time saver, there are several other methods to factor trinomials with a leading coefficient not equal to 1. And I have several other videos that talk about the trial and error method, the grouping method, and a method called bottoms up. So while if you do recognize this pattern, it will save you some time, there are other ways to factor these types of problems. Let's go and take a look at some examples. Again, notice we have a trinomial. There are no common factors, but we can recognize that the first term and the third term are perfect squares. So if I recognize this, I would just check to see if this is a perfect square trinomial. So I would create my two sets of parentheses. And since 2x times 2x equals 4x squared, I'd put a 2x here and a 2x here. And because 3 squared is equal to 9, I'd put a 3 here and a 3 here. And I'd make them both differences because of the minus sign here in the middle. And now I would check it to make sure that it does work, meaning the inner product and the outer product should give us a negative 12x. If it does, then this is a perfect square trinomial. Notice the inner product is negative 6x. The outer product is also negative 6x, which does give us negative 12x. So this is a perfect square trinomial, which means we can write this as the quantity 2x minus 3 squared. Let's go ahead and try another. Again, noticing the first term is a perfect square, as well as the third term, we're going to check to see if this is a perfect square trinomial. If we square 4x, we'll get 16x squared, so we'll put a 4x here and a 4x here. And since 7 squared is equal to 49, we'll put a 7 here and a 7 here. And then lastly, since we have a sum in the middle, we'll have two sums in our factors. Now let's go ahead and check this. The inner product is 28x. The outer product is also 28x, which does give us 56x. This does check, and we can rewrite this as the quantity 4x plus 7 raised to the second power. Let's go and take a look at a couple more. Here we have 25x squared minus 10x plus 1. Again, notice the first term's a perfect square, third term's a perfect square. So let's go ahead and see if we can factor this. 25x squared is the same as 5x raised to the second. So we'll put a 5x here and a 5x here. And since 1 squared is equal to 1, we'll put a 1 here and a 1 here. Again, we have a difference in the middle. So we'll try a minus here and a minus here. And now we'll check it. Inner product is negative 5x. Outer product is negative 5x, which does give us negative 10x. So it checks. It is a perfect square trinomial. So we'll have the quantity 5x minus 1 raised to the second. Okay, on the last example, we do have to be a little more careful. Even though the first term is a perfect square, and so is the third term, we can't forget about the first step in any factoring problem. And the first step is to look for the greatest common factor. And each of these terms do have a common factor of 4. So we need to factor out the GCF before we do anything else. If we factor out 4, we'll have x squared plus 4x plus 4. And now we can see if we can factor the trinomial. So we'll bring down our factor of 4 and then look for two binomial factors. Now here we have a trinomial with a leading coefficient of 1. So we can go back to the old way of factoring this, where we place the factors of x in the first position and then determine the factors of positive 4 that add to positive 4. That would be a positive 2 and a positive 2. So this is a perfect square trinomial, but because the leading coefficient is 1, we can use a different technique if we wish. So this would give us 4 times the quantity x plus 2 raised to the second power. Now I do want to show that if we didn't factor the 4 out, what it would look like. We might make our two sets of parentheses here, and then since this is a perfect square where 2x times 2x would give us 4x squared, and since 4 times 4 is equal to 16, we might use these factors and then use a sum. The problem with this is that notice there is a common factor of 2 in this binomial and another common factor of 2 in this binomial, and therefore it's not factored completely. And that's why we always have to remember that we want to factor out the greatest common factor first before applying any other technique. Okay, I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching.